This is not a drill. We have four new Zayn tracks.
And everything's gonna be all right. Ariana just dropped new music.
And Iggy Azalea reveals that she had a psychotic breakdown.
All this and more on today's rundown.
It's so good to be alive, because it's Friday.
Oh, I was wondering where you were going with
and
that.
And we're on the Daily Hollywood Rundown. Ersti's here.
I know.
Mean, it feels so right.
Also good to be alive because Ariana Grande has dropped new music and is a cut skit from her stint on SNL.
So we all know Ariana Grande was the host and musical guest on Saturday Night Live this weekend, and apparently there's more where that came from, because SNL has uploaded to their YouTube channel a cut skit. They didn't have time to show it, so they put it on YouTube. Ariana Grande plays the legend Judy Garland in a made-up classic space movie from 1961, and it's called Up We Go in Our Fantastic Rocket, where she saves her ship from aliens through song and dance. Check out her amazing Judy Garland impression.
Forget your troubles, come on, get happy. Wipe your cares away. Shout hallelujah, come on, get ready. Get ready, out of space, hooray.
So Ariana Grande saves the world with her amazing voice.
Is there anything she can't do?
Who can't she impersonate?
I know, I mean, I can't even impersonate myself.
I mean, on SNL she did Celine Dion, Rihanna, so many people, Britney Spears, and now Judy Garland.
Judy Garland is one of my favorite actresses of all time, so I had like high hopes for this, and then I saw it and I was like, nailed it, she nailed it.
I know, but there's more, because a new single from her album Dangerous Woman has been released. It's called Be All Right, and I'm not sure if it's an official single or not, but it should be. It's my new favorite song of hers ever. It's club ready, it's so dancey, and it sings about how even though if you're going through rough patches with someone in a relationship, everything's gonna be all right. And she Instagrammed a ton of teasers of this song because she's super excited about it as well. And check this one out. Ariana captioned that video, "We've been waiting so long to share this one with the world. One of my favorites. Thank you guys so much for supporting me and listening to my music. I love you."
This is totally Misty's jam right now. I do love it. I think it sounds a lot like The Way, one of her first songs that ever got big.
Weird.
For me, I like it, but this is like your
anthem. I'm loving it. Oh my God, I'm so loving it. Beginning reminds us of Mariah Carey a little bit too.
Yes, old school. Mm-hmm. And I wonder if she wrote this post Big Sean or was involved in writing this post Big Sean.
Maybe when it was when she was dating that backup dancer.
Was
it Ricky, is that his name? The Donut Gate?
Are they not together anymore?
We don't really know.
I'm not sure, but anyway, I like the song, but Misty's like obsessed, Ariana.
Dying.
Well, Vogue surprised us today by putting together a really low budget music video for Rihanna's single Work, which is really similar to that you remember of Carly Rae Jepsen's Call Me Maybe music video back in the day.
Oh my God, old school.
Yeah, where a bunch of celebrities are like submitting videos themselves, lip syncing. But this time, they're not lip-syncing to Carly Rae Jepsen. It's Rihanna's turn.
What?
So some of the faces you will see in this are Kevin Hart, who I loved, Zendaya got in on the slayage, Cara Delevingne, Kendall Jenner, and speaking of Big Sean, Big Sean 2. And here's a little sneak peek. Drop to celebrate, of course, their April cover girl, which is, of course, Rihanna.
She's looking hot on that cover.
And I love that a lot of these celebrities didn't know the words, because I still don't know the words.
No one knows the words. That's the thing. Oh, I love that it's open for interpretation, and I love it when celebrities aren't afraid to sort of lip sync or cover or mash up someone else's songs. Like, they're not afraid.
I love that you said it's open to interpretation. I'm pretty sure Rihanna didn't mean it that way.
Well,
but
it's twerk, twerk, twerk. My interpretation of work.
Mine's derp, 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 derp,
See?
Derp.
We have some new Iggy Azalea news.
That's
we haven't talked about her in a while.
I know, it's been a minute.
We're going to talk about her new song, and then we're going to talk about some other more heavy stuff. So today she dropped a sort of dance slash lyric video for her song Team. It's from her new album, Digital Distortion, and it sings about how you only need yourself for your team. And in the song, it's interesting because she name checks Kylie Jenner. She says, "Watch a new car dash, call my Kylie." I don't even know what that means. So, but check out a snippet of the song here. So in the video, dancers are wearing denim. They're like in this warehouse. It's giving me some 90s vibes. But for the song, I feel like there's a lot going on.
There is.
It's a little futuristic.
Speaking of open to interpretation, it's Friday, forgive me. Watch a new Kardashian call my Kylie. What the F does that mean?
I think that maybe I should have included more lyrics to put it in context better. So I'm not sure.
I want to know what you guys think it means. Now, speaking of Iggy, we know last year she canceled her tour. No one really knew the reason why, but now she is speaking out to a magazine called Shawn Magazine, talking about some of the reasons why she canceled her tour last year. She said, quote, "I had to have a psychotic breakdown last year. Now we're going to do North America and the rest of Europe, which I didn't feel like I was in the place to do that last time. I felt tired and stressed out, but she is feeling better." And she says that the reason why she got in so many feuds was, quote, "You don't want someone else writing your narrative and making you the villain. Then I just realized, you know what? You can't control it."
I don't understand why she said she had to have that breakdown.
Yeah, I think it got really stressful for her. It got stressful for me talking about her every day. Everybody was throwing her shade. Everybody had an opinion on what she was doing. It seemed like she was the popular girl to hate last year. Kind of felt bad for her. So when you get all that negative press constantly and people, trolls, just tweeting hate at you all day long, I totally get it.
And I hate that she also said that she wishes she could erase the last year of her life.
That
sort of breaks
so
my heart a little bit. I hope that 2016 gets better for Iggy.
New music is coming. It's going to get better. So I hope you guys are interested in music today because we have a lot of music news. So weird. So Zayn did a live Periscope this morning. Periscope is totally my jam, by the way. I really love it. So about 100,000 people tuned in, and he was taking requests from his fans about the songs on his album that they wanted to hear. And he literally debuted 5 songs that we haven't heard before. Wow. So the first song he teased was She, and then the second one was called She Don't Love Me, and we're gonna give you a little taste of that right now. She puts a spirit in a black cap. She always knows where the crowd's at. She puts her mouth by a cigarette. I put it out cause she likes that. Nigga, I know she don't love me. That's why I'm his collaboration that he's doing with Kalani called Wrong.
Ooh, I love Kalani.
So a lot of his fans were asking him to play his single Drunk because, I mean,
that's
I'm curious,
what I would want to hear.
Right? Like, what is that song about? So it took him a minute to find it, which was kind of weird. He's like, oh, I can't find it. I'm like, your album's dropping next week. How do you not have that track lined up in your playlist? But he did play it, and it sounds similar to all the other ones. And finally, he played a song called T.I.O. Take It Off.
I love that. Take it off, just take it off.
Take it off, take it off, just take it off. Thoughts on Zayn's album? Let us know in the comments if you like it. I think everything's thematically going together really well. I think this is an album you're going to listen to from front to end on repeat all the time. Very similar to Justin Bieber's Purpose album.
And who does he want to take it off? Like everyone? He wants everyone to take it off?
Yeah.
So many questions. But I want to know if you are loving Ariana Grande's Be Alright song as much as I am.
Yeah.
Please say that you are.
Please say that you are.
About it. And then comment on my Instagram about it. Comment on Aaron's Instagram about it. Hey, Aaron Robinson. I'm just mistaking because I'm boring.
No.
Yeah.
Some other Aaron Robinson took my name.
Oh, thanks for hanging out. It's Friday. I get to go home now.
You do get to go home. And you guys have an awesome weekend and do some homework or something.
Bye.
Aw, so sad. Adele gets emotional while she performs in London in that box on the left.
Or click to the right to check out Taylor Swift and Calvin Harris's epic PDA-filled vacation. So much romance goals right there.